Hey, what is going on, everybody out there in YouTube lands? Revolution on Cowboy here, and I'm back with a vlog video slash channel update. Because I kind of have a slight announcement regarding RHC Reviews, I apologize, the last 2 weeks I haven't been able to put it up, and I just recently got my new mouse because my old one decided to malfunction and not work right. Haven't got around to editing my new video because I've been busy with other things, like I went to WWE SmackDown taping slash main event last night here in my hometown, Wichita, Kansas, at the Intrust Bank Arena. So that's one factor, and then I also was busy watching the Royals game last night, which the Royals didn't do so well, but only game one. And I'm going to give you guys a little bit of a review of the show. I won't spoil much of SmackDown, but I'll give you a little bit of thoughts on the rest, main event, and some of the dark matches. And then I'll get to my little announcement about RHC Reviews number 29 and just the future of RHC Reviews, which, by the way, speaking of my mouse, I showed in a video yesterday that I have my new mouse, and I destroyed my old one. I suggest you guys go back and watch me just go to town with the old mouse, smash it with a hammer. It's pretty fun. I hope you guys get a good laugh out of it. But first, let's talk about the WWE show. Of course, this is my sixth show in total, believe it or not. I didn't go too many shows back when I first became a fan, because I didn't always have people who could take me to shows until I met my friend Zach, and we've been going to all these shows we can. I've been to 4 SmackDowns, a live show, and even a Raw, which they have yet to bring Raw back to Wichita, Kansas. I hope they do soon. They've mostly only brought house shows back during the brand, split days, but so far they've brought more SmackDowns than anything else. But yeah, it was a good show. I won't spoil a lot about SmackDown, but I'll say one thing. Dean Ambrose definitely stole the show. And the Cesaro-Ziggler match for the IC title was pretty good. I won't say who won that. You have to watch yourself. And then AJ Lee always puts on a good show, as usual. Because she's a cutie. I like AJ Lee. And the rest of the show was meh. Typical SmackDown, predictable. But other than that, it was still enjoyable. And I always like seeing it live more than watching it on TV. Then when it comes to main event was pretty good. There was a good opening segment with Golden Stardust and the Usos doing a How Do You Know Your Partner? And JBL's the host of it. And Stardust, man. Cody Rhodes, man. He's something else. He is Stardust! It's like, oh my god. They made Goldust seem more like the level-headed of the two. As he does that little hiss. And JBL's like, don't hiss me. And then the dancing part with him and the Usos, JBL and the Usos. That was crazy. But then, of course, there was the matches. Big E versus Bo. Big E got the win. Alright match. Bo didn't believe enough. Then there was the Kid and R-Truth match, which, R-Truth came very close to accidentally knocking over, Natalya, which he stopped. And then, Tyson Kidd took advantage. And he also faked an ankle injury. Then there was the main event of main event, which I thought was a good match, and I will say something pretty cool here in a moment, but good match. Swagger Puss, a good offense, of course, the Stooges got involved, Zeb almost got into a fight with them, and of course ended with, Rollins doing a curb stomp to Swagger. Now, I am going to point this out, and believe me if you want to. If you don't believe me, that's fine. During the match, when Swagger was in a submission hold by Rollins, you will hear a We the People chant, like, We the People. That was me, believe it or not. I was the one to start that chant. I didn't start the, main chants of We the People. That Swagger starts that, obviously, but when you hear the We the People chant in the background, if you can, I don't know if it's audible, if I was loud enough, but once I started chanting it, everybody else started following. And eventually the entire arena started chanting We the People to pump Swagger up to get him out of that submission. So once again, believe me if you want to. If you don't believe me, that's fine. If you can hear me, cool. If you were able to watch the main event and heard my voice, then hey, awesome. Or if you have a chance to watch it again on the network, because you always can, then, go back and watch it and see if you can hear my voice. Because that is me in the crowd. And you also will see me on SmackDown this Friday. I was actually not wearing this shirt. This was the shirt I was holding up. I was wearing my Just Bring It Rock shirt. So if you see somebody wearing a Just Bring It shirt in the background, behind some people with blue signs, that is me. And there are a few times with the Ambrose segments, I have either thrown up the metal horns or threw up this shirt I actually bought at the show. So you will see that. I mean, there was also another, like a girl that had this shirt too, that was also hold it up. But you'll see me somewhere. Now, speaking of stuff of the show, I just mentioned I bought this shirt. I also bought this AJ Lee Pop vinyl. It's the first one I ever bought. Pretty cool. It's only $10 a show, and people want, God, up to $40 for it on eBay. So I thought, why not? Might as well buy it. I haven't bought anything like a figure at a show since the last time they had figures. And I thought I'd buy some pop vinyl the last time I was at Walmart. I saw, like, The Rock, Austin, Cena. I almost picked up Rock and Austin, but I didn't. But I'll have to now that I have the AJ Lee pop vinyl. And on the back, I cannot wait for Hogan, Daniel Bryan, Macho Man. When their pop vinyls come out, you know, whether it be Toys R Us or if they ever at Walmart, I'm going to have to get them, definitely. Still, pretty cool pop vinyl. I'm glad to have it. I mean, why not? Box got bent up a little. That's a downside, so I might end up taking out of the box. I don't know. I'm not somebody who really cares about the value of the boxes as much, but, oh well, it's still nice to have, and I'm glad to have it. Well, that's about it for my, little thoughts on the, WWE show that was here in town. Definitely can't wait till the next time we have one, and please, WWE, bring Raw back! We need another Raw. Raw is so much more awesome. Now that that's out of the way, I do want to talk about RHC Reviews real quick. I gotta be honest, in the time that my mouse decided to break on me and I wasn't using it, I kind of enjoyed the time off of not making reviews. I don't know, it's just starting not to be worth it anymore. It's not because I'm not getting the views or anything. I understand that it's going to take time, but, and I don't mind answering your guys' questions on the Q&A. It's just, I don't know, I'm just not enjoying it like I thought I was. I've recently got back into fan art, because before I came to YouTube, as an active video maker, I was doing drawing a lot more. Then things happened in my life. I turned to YouTube. I thought it was a great place to meet our collectors, and it was at the time. And I was mostly doing toy videos, just toy pickups and toy runs. Reviews weren't even a, you know, thing for me at the time. And then I started doing trade card videos, which that kind of increased my sub count a lot, seeing that there's a big trade card collecting community. But I don't know, I've kind of fallen out of love with YouTube as of late. I mean, I miss the old days when I used to really enjoy it. And I'm pressuring myself to make these reviews look good, and they don't. And they're just not getting the feedback that I want. And I don't know. I want to make to review number 30, and I don't know what I'm going to do for review 30. Maybe I'll do my collection or something as a review. I don't know, because after review 30, I might be done. It's just, it was fun at first, but I'm not enjoying it, especially after the time I took off last year of all the crap that was happening here at my house. Otherwise, I probably would have been probably to review 60 or something by now if it weren't for all that. But what can you do? Shit happens, you move on. So, I hope to have Review 29 up this week. It might be up tomorrow, it might be up Friday, it might be up Saturday, because, hey, I should have no problem editing it together now that I have my mouse. And then I have one question that was asked for me for the Q&A segment of number 30, and I think after that, I mean, I might keep the Q&A going, make the Q&A a separate segment, and then just do shout-outs every now and then. But, yeah, that's really about it. I might still do vlogs, toy runs, pickups, which I'm still waiting on my Amazon package to come to me. It has not been shipped yet, so hopefully Amazon's not having too much problems getting some of my stuff that may either stock. I mean, I don't know. So that's about it. I thank you guys for watching this video. As always, you know, feel free to comment for the heck of it. And let me know if you saw me on Main Event or heard me, or, you know, if you're watching this video Saturday or something after SmackDown's aired, let me know if you did see me on TV. I really do appreciate it. Anyways, guys, as always, thanks for watching, rock on, and keep collecting.